Vasilopoulos started in 1973 in Mora, Minnesota. There was 96 skiers in the first race. In 1974, it increased to 201 skiers. In 1975, there was 258. 1977, there was no race because there was not enough snow. In 1980, it broke the 1,000 mark for participants. There was 1,100 registered. 1981, the registration went down to just over 1,000. In 1984, they are expecting over 2,000. They expected over 2,000 people. 1985, they are expecting probably around 2,500. The Vasilopoulos winners, starting with 1973, Sean Kuss took first place with a time of 2 hours and 12 minutes. 1974, Art Raken of Newport, a Finnish exchange student, took first with a time of 2 hours, 3 minutes, and 55 seconds. 1975, Oyster Loseth of Marina in the St. Croix, Minnesota, took first with a time of 2 hours, 2 minutes, and 20 seconds. 1976, when the race was built up to 50 kilometers, Andy Desmond of St. Louis Park took 3 hours, 26 minutes, and 35 seconds. In 1977, there was no race because there was not enough snow. 1978, the 58-kilometer race, Lars Vinius of Vidigana, Sweden, took first with a time of 3 hours, 14 minutes, and 30 seconds. 79 and 80, Pierre Nodden of Gavan, Norway, took first with times of 3:12, 05, and 2:42, 26, respectively. 1981, Walt Humer of St. Paul, Minnesota, won with a time of 4 hours, 38 minutes, and 45 seconds. 1982, Stan Fjeldholm took first with a time of 2 hours, 43 minutes, and 40 seconds. 1983, Jan Bjorkholm of Oslo, Norway took first with a time of 3:37.06. The best time in the Vasilopoulos at 32. In 1981, we had George Walk of Hayward, Wisconsin with 2:16.20. 1982, we had Björn Hassis of Orsa, Sweden with 1:24.09. In 1983, we had Rolf Homer of Mora, Sweden with a time of 2:09.45. The Mora Vasilopoulos plays a big part in the community. It has been a strictly community effort, staged by volunteers with no government grant money involved, and not a great deal of contribution by sponsors, although they are certainly welcome. Nowhere is the help of the volunteers more apparent than in trail preparation. Starting with preparations for the 1984 race, a new concept in organizing volunteer trail workers was employed. 9 teams were named, each to be responsible for 10 kilometers of the 90-kilometer length of both 58 and 32 trails. The teams each were given an identity named after woodland trees. The teams and their captains were the Birch Team, with Bob Lindick captain, the Maple Team, the Red Oak Team, the White Oak Team, the Popple, the Willow, the Pine, Basswood, and the Ash Team. Each team was issued special leaf-shaped patches identifying their team, and special jackets were made available to them to help build up a spirit of unity and friendly competition between them. Individual teams are also being encouraged to enter the race in the upcoming years, and a special competition division to further encourage this spirit. The whole concept is designed to make the work of trail preparation easier for everyone and result in an even better competitive conditions on race day. The award ceremony is held each year after the race, starting at about 3:30 p.m. It is held at the Mora, the high school auditorium in Mora, with all the winners of the Vasilopoulos at 58 and 32 medals and trophies given their awards. The Mora Classic and American-Swedish exchange medal winners are also given their awards at this ceremony. Various visiting dignitaries are also introduced at this time. Notables that were at the 1984 awards ceremony included the Governor of Minnesota, Rudy Perpich, and the Lieutenant Governor, Marlene Johnson. The Swedish Consul General in Minneapolis was also on hand, and invitations were sent to Minnesota Tourism Director Hank Todd and Ginger Sisko of the also of the Minnesota Tourism Department, as well as Kit Foley of the Minnesota Air Hoid Association. A special flag presentation is annually carried out by the local troop of the Boy Scouts, which initiates the program. Awards are presented by present and former Kranskalas to the skiers. The Kranskala is one of the traditions that was borrowed from the Swedish Vasaloppet. The Kranskala, or wreath girl, welcomes the skiers with a victor's wreath and various medals. The wreath made of lemon leaves is placed around the neck of the winner of each race to symbolize the victory. The idea to use the Kranskala at the North American Vasaloppet was suggested to the board by Mrs. Daisy Samuelsson. She and her husband Eric were both born in Mora, Sweden, and anxious to see many of the Swedish traditions established here. To serve as the Kranskala is an honor sought by many, and the selection is not always an easy task. The women chosen must be interested cross-country skiers who have given their time to work on the Vasaloppet. The honor of serving as the Kranskala is considered a special reward for her work. Throughout the race weekend and the year that follows, the Kranskala is presented at various community functions dressed in traditional Swedish garb. The most important function, however, is the bestowing of the victor's wreath, as well as the medals earned by skiers as they cross the finish line. In 1976, Daisy Samuelsson was the first Kranskala. In 1977, there was none, because again, there was no race. 1978, Dolores Salmonson was the Kranskala. 1979, one of the teachers at Mora High School, Nancy Larson, was the Kranskala. 1980, Muriel Broberg. 1981, Beatrice Johnson. In 1982, Mary Locken was chosen as a Kranskala. 1983, Bev Harris. And 1984, Donna Olsen as a Kranskala. The Mora Vasaloppet is now part of the annual Mora Classic Series. It is beginning its fifth annual time of running. The first event of the Mora Classic Series is the Snake River Canoe Race. It is a 25-kilometer race from the Hinckley Road Bridge to Mora, including a 300-meter portage at the finish. Awards are given in three racing classes, men, women, and mixed teams. Then we have the Vasa Runners Half Marathon, which starts sometime in mid to late August. It is a 13.1-mile course, which starts downtown and ends up downtown. Then we have the Vasa Runners Bike Tour, which is towards the end of September. It is an 80-kilometer bike ride from downtown Mora over paved country roads back into Mora. And then we have the Mora Vasaloppet. We have the choice of the 58-kilometer or the 32-kilometer. The race begins up at Warman, 15 miles north of Mora, and ends at downtown. The race consists of many control points and blueberry stops along the way. In the 58-kilometer race, there is a stop in Haybrook at the 6.5-kilometer mark for blueberry stop and control point. There is one at Peace, at Richards, Dalby's, Knife Lake, Matheson's, and then the finish. Blueberry stops were invented a couple of years ago. They consist of a blueberry soup mix, which is very good for the skiers, keeps them warm, and provides them with the water and nutrition they need for the race. The medal program of the Mora Vasaloppet was redesigned in 1983. The winner's medals in the first 25 places of the Vasaloppet feature the skier and bell tower on the front and imprinted on the back with year and their placement. As in the past, the first place will earn a 10-karat gold medal, a twin sterling silver medal will go to second, and third is awarded with a single sterling silver medal. Silver plate and bronze medals are awarded to a balance of the first 25 finishers, as well as time and a half medals to all finishing within 1.5 times the winner's time. The medal program was instituted in 1976, and with the exception of completion medals given to all finishers in both the Vasaloppet and the Old Dalaloppet, it applies only to the 58-kilometer race. USSA Central Marathon Series. It is set up by the Central Division of the USSA. The past few years, ski marathoning has grown faster than any other type of cross-country skiing competition, so Central's cross-country committee decided to establish a marathon series in Central incorporating existing races at or near the marathon distance. USSA Central Division is a part of the U.S. Ski Association, the national governing body for the wintering skiing sports of alpine, cross-country, jumping, and freestyle. USSA is licensed by the world governing body, the International Ski Federation, FIAS, and recognized by the U.S. Olympic Committee as the sole national federation for winter skiing. Membership in the Central Marathon. In the Central Membership Series is just $10 for a five-year period. There's a $5 per year fee for those taking part in a special marathon pin series. All registrants will receive a Central Marathon Series patch and a passport book to record all of the race finishes. One of the most exciting aspects of the Central Marathon Series is the annual USSA Marathon Pin Series. Pins can be earned by skiers who in one season complete 3 of the 10 events for a bronze, 5 for a silver, or 7 for a gold. Skiers can also earn a certificate of completion by completing all 10 events in a 5-year period. Skiers not completing the required events in the time period must rejoin and begin again. One of the great awards that has existed almost throughout the entire history of the Mora Vassalopa is the Mora Nisi Award, given by Enid Johnson of Svenskar Dog of Minneapolis. The very first race saw special recognition to the winner by SVD, but it was not called the Mora Nisi Award until a second race in 1974, and the award did not achieve its present status until a 1976 race. At that time, in addition to the plaque presented to the winner of the current race, permanent plaques were established to hang at the headquarters of both the Mora USA and Mora Sweden Vassalopas, inscribed with each year's winners. This practice is still followed, and the Mora Nisi plaque is a coveted award for the Vassalopas.